actor, my sins were forgiven.
Oh yeah.
Started out from higher ground
to climb
the ladder round by round.
And will I
climb it higher and higher, and I won't come down.
The first round was regeneration,
still climbing.
The second round, justification,
still climbing.
The third, I have a confession,
still climbing.
The Holy Ghost to possession,
still climbing.
The next round was great tribulation,
still climbing.
Soul to glorification,
still climbing. Climbing higher and higher, and I won't come down.
I'm gonna climb till I pass the sun, moon, and stars, Jupiter, Venus, Neptune, and Mars. I'll be farewell to this old house of clay, and then I go running up the Milky Way.
First heaven,
I'm climbing round by round.
Second heaven,
I'm so high I never come down. Still climbing round by round, climbing from higher ground. Well, 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 well.
All the climbs that I pass, the sun, moon, and stars, Jupiter, Venus, Neptune, and Mars. I'll be farewell to this old house of clay,
and then I go running up the Milky Way.
I'm first to heaven,
I'm climbing around and around.
A second heaven,
I'm so high I never come down. Woo! Still climbing around by around, climbing the higher ground.
A ladder taking a
hell, I'm climbing around by around.
A second heaven,
I'm so high.
Amen. Praise God. God is good. Amen. I mean, hey, it's better felt than it is told, my friend. But today we're talking about, rewards and works. Works and reward. We're not talking. If you're just joining in the program, please go back, listen to the archive. Get the whole conclusion of a matter that you may give an honest balance and judgment. Amen? All right. Praise God. We love you. That's the simplest way I know to do it. But we do thank God for you. And you're listening to The Pulpit, and I am your host, Evangelist Eddie Chaney. So look at John chapter 5, verse 28. And 29, do not marvel at this, for an hour is coming in which all who are in the tomb shall hear his voice and shall come forth. Those who did the good deeds to a resurrection of life, those who committed the evil deeds to a resurrection of judgment. Wow. I got a feeling that we need to be busy about the Father's business. We need to be doers of the Word of God. We need to be active in our community, in our church, on our job site, in our neighborhood, our front yard, our backyard. Yes, we need to be a light to a lost and dying world. Interesting. Look at Romans chapter 2, verse 6 through 7. God will render to every man according to his deeds, to those who by perseverance and doing good seek for glory and honor and immortality, eternal life. Think about it. Romans chapter 2, verses 6 and 7. Hey, look at 2 Corinthians 5, verse 10. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, that each one of us may be recompensed for his deeds in the body, according to what he has done, whether good or bad. Now, later, Paul referred to false apostles whose end shall be according to their deeds. Wow. Ain't that something? I mean, you need to look at chapter 11, verse 15. 2 Corinthians, chapter 5, verse 10. Also check out chapter 11, verse 15. Hey, look at 2 Timothy, chapter 4, verse 14. Paul says, Alexander the corporal smith did me much harm. The Lord will repay. Look at the King James, because he's talking about reward him according to his deeds. And I understand, y'all, that everybody has different Bibles this day and time, different references. So you really want to jump in there. A lot of the comments I'm saying in the King James Version. Amen. But I understand that everybody's seeking. I encourage you to seek and pray about the Word of God and allow God to write His Word upon the tablet of your heart, my friend. Amen. Amen. I want you to look at 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 17. Would you do that? Yeah, I'm going to be giving you the Word of God on this topic of works and our deeds and good works. If you're claiming to be born again, bathed in the blood, shouldn't you be doing good things? Shouldn't you be striving to be Christ-like? Shouldn't you be helping those in your community, those right there next door, those in your backyard, those in your front yard, those all involved in your life? Wherever you go, shouldn't you let your light shine? Shouldn't you take an opportunity to tell and show people about the love of God? Now listen, you can say you love me all day long, and you can say you enjoy this program, but until you comment, until you get active, until you become a part of it, those words don't mean very much to me. You've got to put them into action. You see, work without faith is dead, my friend. You gotta do something. You got to show your love by supporting, by praying, obeying God, by saying, hey, I love you, man. And then when there's a need arises, you show your love. That's how it works. You're either real or you're not. You're either lost or you're saved. You're either on your way to heaven or you're going to split hell wide open. Everybody that jumps the highest ain't got the Holy Ghost. Everybody packing the Bible ain't saved. And that's the truth. So today we're talking about our works. You can't work your way into heaven, but if you're born again, if you're bathed in the blood, if you're a child of God, that's what I'm talking to you about. Or you not be doing good works, or you not be busy in the kingdom of God, or you not trying to tell people about Jesus by showing them the love of God. Love covers a multitude of sin. Jesus showed up. Jesus went home with people. Jesus was involved in their lives. Jesus was a doer, man, not just a hearer, not just somebody that quoted life-changing words, but he applied them and did them and moved and done. An action is involved. If you say you love God, then you will be doing good things, because you are striving to be Christ-like, and that's all he done, went about doing good. What have you done today for the kingdom of God? You're listening to The Pulpit, and we're talking about works and rewards. Will some receive a greater reward for their great service for their in this kingdom of God? We'd love to hear from you. You can call us at 1-931-229-0768. Leave a comment or a prayer request, a question, or just shout howdy. Either way, I would love to hear from you. It lets us know that we're reaching out to a lost and dying world. It lets us know that you're praying for us. It lets us know that you're there. We'd love to hear from you. Amen. Praise God. God is just awesome, and besides him, there is none other, my friend. If you're listening today and you don't know this man, Jesus, we're talking about, well, today is the day of salvation, my friend. You see, without the Spirit of God, you cannot discern spiritual things. You have no idea what I'm talking about if you're not born again. Well, let me tell you this. Before you go any further in the program, if you do not know Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, take this moment, take this hour, take this day, it's yours, and get things settled between you and God. Cast your cares upon him, for he cares for you. He loves you. He knows about the drug infestation, the alcohol, the abuse, the lying, the whoremongering. He knows more about you than you even know about yourself. You see, there's no secret thing with God. He knows everything. Confess your faults. Confess your sins to him. Run into the arms of the great I am. Reach out. Grab a hold of that unchanging hand. Repent and turn from your wickedness. And allow God, yes, to rise you up a new creature in Christ Jesus. Man, the things you used to would do, you won't do no more. Places you used to would go, you won't want to go no more. You see, God will take out that old stony heart and he'll give you a new one, my friend. A heart of love, a heart of action, a heart of doing the will of the Father. We've got work to do and time's running out, my friend. Right now, repent. Cast your cares upon Jesus. It's that simple. Hey, let us know if you've accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior throughout one of our programs. Leave it in the comment box or call us at 1-931-229-0768. Now, feel free to ask any questions. If you're in the Crossville, Tennessee area, we would recommend that you stop by at Pomona United Methodist Church, meet Pastor Lewis Davis. That is one of my pastors in my life. And when I'm evangelizing here in Crossville, Tennessee, I try to get everybody in there to the Word of God, to the man of God, to say, hey, you need to sit down and talk. Feel free to get a hold of Pastor Lewis Davis. He'll talk with you, pray with you, share. He'll break the Word of God with you. Me, you can call me too anytime at 931-229-0768. I'll talk with you. I'll come to your house. I'll sit down. I'll sup with you. Man, I'll explain Jesus the best way that I can, amen, by just being a doer of the Word of God. But I travel a lot. I'm not in town a lot. I'm in different states. I am an evangelist called and ordained by God. But I don't like leaving the sheep out without getting them into the fold. Whatever state I'm in, I work with different pastors and different ministries to get them into the herd, man. There's protection in numbers. There's power. Do you hear me? In numbers, and whether you like it or not, you're part of the body of Christ. This ain't no one-man rodeo, and you can't, you know that song, Me and Jesus Got Our Own Thing Going. I mean, you can't just get in the bedroom and think, okay, this is it. I've got God. I'm going to stay right here. I'm not going back out in the world. Man, you liable to miss heaven, because to know to do good and you do it not, to you it is sin. And if we got some good to do, we got to be doers of the Word of God. We got to visit some widows and orphans, and we got to feed the hungry. We got to clothe the naked. We got to visit those that are shut up in prisons and jails. In other words, man, we got a lot of work to do, and we're going to make a lot of people mad as hell is hot, but that is beside the point. We've got to be busy because we love God. And if you're a child of God and you've got the love of God in you and you see a need, you're going to do something about it. They don't have to ask. You're going to do something because you know there's a need. And the love of God is what's shaping you and leading and guiding you. You're striving to be Christ-like. You're going to go around doing good. And when you do that, man, you make the devil mad. I mean, you think you've been in war. You think you've seen a battle. You ain't seen nothing till you step up to go to work for the kingdom of God. And then every demon in the pits of hell come at you. Every thought you can think. The devil is seeking whom he may destroy. Do you hear me? There is a war, whether you want to admit it or not, whether you believe it or not. We are at war, and there's a soul hanging in the balance. So that's why God put this word upon my heart this morning to share with you. Surely the Bible shows that genuine faith in Jesus Christ will exhibit itself in genuine acts of good deeds, godliness, and righteous living. Surely, surely it will. If you're born again, surely you're going to take the bushel off of your light. Surely, surely people can see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. Surely God has called you and chosen you. Surely you are important in the body of Christ. This day, my friend, apply the Word of God in your life and go forth in Jesus' name.